good. I'm Franklin. Some people call me Mr. Roosevelt.
Mr. Roosevelt. Tom, get a little closer so I can get you and President Roosevelt together here.
Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to remind you that this weekend is being brought to you in part by...
Good, good.
Maybe a couple of lines from one of your famous speeches, just a couple sentences?
Well, sure. Now, this is a speech that was my least favorite speech, but people know it most. Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy, the United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. It's called the Day of Infamy speech from Pearl Harbor.
Thank you, Mr. President.
My pleasure.
That guy does horizontal.
Going very much.
It's moving on. It's on autopilot.
This lever's a brake. The brake is broken. I mean, not bad for something that's 80 some years old.
Yeah, the
Luger. Mm-hmm. Oh, what an interesting looking.
I know, I was looking at those too.
They're so fired
together.
Yeah, and then you have to go like that.
That wasn't the main pistol in World War II.
Yeah, I think
it went to the PPK.
Not the Walter? Oh, yeah, the
P-38. Yes, the P-38.
P-38 Walter,
service thing. This was like from guards.
Yeah.
And I guess in a pinch they had to.
Hey!
Oh, pass the hat, our people.
Yeah.
We don't talk about, they had black powder single shot rifles and very, very obsolete weapons. And also, the minute they saw trouble, they ran the other way. The Philippine scouts, they held their ground, they sank their teeth in. And you know, they did their best with what they could.
Everybody had to blow it, add water to it, but then change the barrel.
Five rounds. That's how everyone's trying to work. The hole! Fire in the hole!
Wow.
That's a lot faster than the bad guys. So now you have a squad of 12 GIs, 10 of them carrying M1 rifles. You saw the Eel's base of fire. You've got 10 angry soldiers firing as fast as they can. The enemy has to put his head down. Have planks for that. It takes hours to clean it. A 100-year-old design has a specific advantages. It's crazy. There's a spring in there and stuff. And this would fire automatically as well. This looks like a machine.
Thank you much, sir.
45 cal. Yep, but they were overbuilt. The rear sight was very complicated. The rear sight was good for over 1,000 yards away. Who parked in the parking lot today? 500 yards away. If you're at the far side, if you got a crappy spot in the parking lot, you're 600 yards away. This was sighted to go to over 1,000 yards. Completely unnecessary. It did kind of strange things like allowing you to take the buttstock off, which just really means you're going to lose your buttstock and probably never find it. Yeah, but it's easier to put this against it. The barrel was finged. I don't know why. Get rid of heat. It's got a compensator to hold down the muzzle jump of a 45 caliber cartridge. It's not a lot. the internal bolt mechanism went so far as to have a felt oiler. So what can do with the oil itself while you were fighting your enemy? All unnecessary. So they simplified it. The stock didn't come off, no more in barrel, no unnecessary compensator. The rear sight was really just a piece of sheet metal bent and riveted to the gun. Alright, same ammunition, 30-round magazine, utterly reliable. Bolt assembly is now one moving piece with fixed firing. A lot of places. The sword is trying to get they took a lot of time, effort, machinery, and skilled machinists. But the they made a lot of basically the same stuff to make it hard as a system. It was the right gun at the right time in the right place. They couldn't afford time. So the stand gun was a good, low-cost, effective way to make a gun. And the Germans took note of that. They'll never beat the Germans at a design table. So with metal stamping and steel tubing, they built the elegant MP40, a very serviceable submachine. The Americans had to figure out a different way to make a gun cheaper. So what's a good company to make a machine gun? Well, a company. How about General Motors? What does General Motors make?
Cars.
Does anyone remember hubcaps? Remember when cars used to have hubcaps?
Yeah.
They built this on a hubcap machine. They stamped out the right half and the left half, and they welded them together. Final government cost was approximately $14.50. That's a lot cheaper than a $450 Thompson submachine gun. Fired the same ammunition. Very portable if you kept it inside of a tank.
That's probably the best
one. Yeah. Different rifles for different jobs.
We got some guys in like 16 that had more stuff. They all can't carry firearms, but they'll set them up. Oh, you are?
Yeah.
Okay, okay, great.
Ammunition, they have fuel, they have electrical systems. Things can get pretty messy on the inside, you know? But that's it, so we carry about 48 of them. Yeah. And if we needed to carry more, we'd strap everything on the outside. So everything that you see here is five crew, right? We've got me as a driver, I'm the second senior guy. And then my tank commander would be like a second lieutenant. And my assistant driver, the hatch is closed now, he would probably be like the lowest of the low. He would be like a private, right? And then you would have two corporals probably as a gunner and a loader. So you have five people. Now, don't forget, we all have our weapons. We all have our clothes. We all have our sleeping bags. We all have got our helmets. We needed extra fuel. We needed extra water. Everything is strapped on the outside. ammunition alone.
Yep.
Here?
Like you guys are right, I got a call.
Right through here.
Nobody
right
was fighting here.
Driver,
you know what?
Right through the engine.
Good. Good.
But
I don't have to do it.
Fast, right? Not
I said, don't not fight in here anymore.
Okay. they made trucks. They made garbage trucks, dump trucks, moving vans, all kinds of stuff. So they knew how to make a truck. They knew how to make a chassis for a truck. They knew how to make a drivetrain and an engine.
Thank you. Thank you. So this is like the World War II version of an Easter egg hunt. People out there looking for brass casings of fireplace ash. So you get a lot of stuff lofted into the air. Makes a big smoke cloud, makes cool stuff coming down, but nobody gets hurt. In fact, fertilizes the grass when we're done. By the way, we do landscaping, as you can see. If any of you people are interested, please contact me. Prices are very reasonable.